Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the shed. I'm Lonnie.
Good morning. I'm Candace. Welcome back.
Candace, it's a friggin' mess in here right now.
Yeah, y'all, we have so much stuff. I mean, we really got a list hard this week because we have so much stuff.
The we means you.
The we is me.
You are the we today, this week.
I'm running the listing show all by myself, I think.
Oh, I got a call. I do have to call the courthouse.
Yeah, tomorrow's jury duty, and he's supposed to call today. I'm hoping when he calls, they're going to say, we don't need you.
Yeah, that would be nice. Yeah. But jury duty does start tomorrow. Hopefully, if I got to do it for a few days, that's fine.
We'll figure it out.
That's fine. The thing I don't want to do, I don't want to get into some like prolonged thing that goes on for weeks.
I know.
That would be very harmful. A couple of days, no big deal.
Yeah, because we're thinking we're going to have to extend handling time from 1 day to two. Just, because if a package comes in late at night, there's
sale.
Yeah.
If a sale comes in at like 1 a.m.
Right.
And we're in our time zone, if a sale comes in at 1 a.m. and we do 1 day handling, we're supposed to ship it the next day.
Right. So, yeah, if it looks like this is going to be a thing, we're going to extend the handle.
As a matter of fact, I think we're going to have to bulk edit tonight before I go to bed.
To change everything
to 2 day handling, yeah, for that reason.
Yeah.
And then we'll see what happens. And we've already talked about it. Like, I'm going to go do my jury duty thing. And unless something really crazy happens, we'll be pulling orders at night when I get off of court.
Maybe you'll get out like in the afternoon, like 2 or something. That would be nice, huh?
Yeah, whatever time I get home, we'll pull orders in and I'll pack then.
Yeah.
And then Candace will just be in here listing or whatever during the day. So videos, while jury duty's going on, videos may be a little shorter and a little less cutting up and storytelling and stuff like that. I know that's not going to be the case. Like, I can never.
We can't help ourselves but to talk.
No, we can't. But we had a pretty decent sales weekend. I did want to leave with a question here because this is actually a point several people made on the video about the cookbooks.
Yeah.
So this was a comment from Paper Time Machine, and I mean, I think they make some good points here, but I think there are some counterpoints that could be made too. Someone said $1 and you offered 40 cents. That's some serious reseller lowballing. And 5 sales in 2 years and you bought 255 of them. Why didn't you just give her $20 for 20 of them and call it a day? So they are talking about the cookbooks. First of all, they didn't say $1. That we were at an estate sale.
Yeah, and the thing about the dollar, she priced that thinking people are going to buy one at a time.
Right.
Right. I mean, you have to take that into consideration too. It was an estate sale the last day, and it was fairly late in the morning. It was not.
It was like what, probably about 10:30 or something.
Yeah.
So it wasn't like it had just opened.
Right.
And look, we're not trying to justify this. If you think what we did was...
Because we would have done that if we had been there when they first opened on.
Right, right. We're not trying to justify any of this. Like, if you think we're lowballers, then you're just going to think that.
Right.
But yeah, the way I look at it, estate sale operator, they have 255 of something that hasn't sold in the previous 3 days or whatever. And it's the last day of the estate sale. And they have them... 255 of something priced at $1 and they want to move them. I will make a similar, as a matter of fact, not only do I think 40 cents was a good offer for 255 of them, I think we should have gone a little lower.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we should have offered a quarter.
She's
honestly,
this estate sale owner. She's very, very nice and very fair, but she's not a pushover.
No, she's firm.
Yeah, she wouldn't. I mean, she would not let us get one over on her, or however you want to put it. You know, she knows what she wants, and she's not afraid to tell us no.
And she's also not afraid to move product when she needs to move product.
Right.
Because, like I said, so yeah, it pretty much in any situation, as far as the price goes. Any situation at all where someone has a price. Like, if she would have had those things priced at 50 cents each, we would have offered a quarter. I promise you. I promise you we would have offered a quarter to buy all. And that goes for any situation where someone is selling, like, a whole bunch of something. We're always going to offer less to buy all of them. And they're usually going to accept it. So, that's just a business, man. Like, that's what we do every time.
And as far as only 5 sales in 2 years, that's because they weren't out in the public. Well, now they're going to be, but they weren't out there for people to sell.
Yeah, you can't, if there were 5, okay, so like before we started listing these things, there was 1 active for $75. So if you say, okay, there's only 5 sales in the last 2 years, if there were 5 sales in the last 2 years, and there were, and there were also 40 actives on eBay, then I would be like, yeah, you're right. There's been plenty of supply, just nobody wants them. But in this case, there's almost no supply, and all the supply that's ever been put up has been bought, except for this one that's priced way above what one has ever sold for before.
Right.
So, I mean, I don't think you can judge. I don't think the 5 sales just means that every time somebody lists one, that's the way I look at it. Every time somebody listed one, it sold, is the way I see it.
And you have to remember, a lot of these cookbooks, these type of cookbooks that we sell, are very short runs. There were not a lot produced in the to begin with.
Right.
It's the ones that you see a lot of, they end up having multiple printings, where this one was just a one-time printing thing.
Yeah. So, I mean, I think these are good questions. I'm not doing this one to, like, make fun of the person that asked it or anything like that. I'm just literally answering the questions.
Yeah, that's our thought process when we're doing a buy like this.
Yeah. Why didn't you just give her $20 for 20 of them and call it a day? Well, let me pose this question back to you. What if we would have given them $20 for 20 of them and called it a day, got home, listed those 20 for $40, and sold them all within a week? How do you think that regret for not buying the other 235 of them would have sat? I would have thought about that cookbook buy every day for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
Honestly, I would have.
Yeah.
So for me, the fear of missing out would have been far worse than the fear of ending up with, you know, spending $60 extra on cookbooks that I didn't need to buy, or $80 more than I should have. If we end up getting stuck with half of them,
it doesn't matter. You sell 3 and your money's back.
Right.
You know, that's right. The way we looked at it.
Right.
It was not a big risk. So.
No. Now that question does get more interesting. I was talking to Candace about this because several other people posed similar questions. That question gets more interesting if the price is, what if we would have had to pay $3 a copy, $4 a copy? Now we're looking at $1,000 out of pocket. What if we would have had to pay $5? What if the minimum would have been $5 a copy?
Right.
Do we still have the same conviction?
No.
Because it's easy to have conviction when
because
something...
Because it's more risk.
Right. Way more risk.
Yeah.
So what would we buy then? Right. How many?
At $5 a copy?
Maybe 20 of them?
Yeah, I mean, well, first of all, on a state sale on Sunday, they're not going to be that high.
Yeah, but what if it was? You know, because...
I don't think we would have bought them.
So, I don't think so either.
I don't think we would have. $5? No.
No, I don't think we would have.
No.
So, I'm talking big here, right? But there's a point where the risk is too much. And 40 cents just was not that point.
Right.
40 cents was such a trivial amount to spend on each one that it wasn't even really a question at that point. As a matter of fact, when we first saw them for a dollar, like, I don't know, I would have felt kind of, even paying a dollar a whack.
Yeah.
And I mean, now knowing what we know now, yeah, we would pay it for sure, but
I think we would have been hesitant even at a dollar.
I think we would have. I think
we would have bought some, but maybe not all of them.
Maybe so, right?
Yeah.
So the thing that makes it so, if you want to argue about the price we paid, that's fine, but paying the 40 cents made the other part of the equation, where you buy them all, easy. Because at that point, I'm like, okay, my potential regret is worth way more than 40 cents.
Right. And let me tell you, it worked for us and it worked for her. She didn't have to figure out a way to get rid of these over 200 cookbooks. They probably would have ended up being donated, I imagine. Some families choose to donate. Some families want stuff back. So it just depends on how the terms.
I bet most families do not want stuff back.
200 cookbooks. They might want to keep some of them. I don't. Or they probably already kept what they wanted to keep.
Or, you know, if they need to later on, they can buy one back from us. That's. But yeah. Speaking of that, we have 6 of those books going out. So I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, I've even got like this big bubble. I didn't know where to put it. I've got 6 of these books going out today. So I'm going to go ahead and grab those. And Candace, I'll pack. I know you have some Monster High dolls to cut out.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go ahead and pack these while Candace is cutting up over there.
I'm going to do some cutting up.
Yeah. But very good question, though, about the cookbooks. I think it does, if you want to say we're greedy for going from $1 to 40 cents to buy $2.55, I can't argue that if you think that. We do buy low and sell high, and a lot of times we will pay the price, but when we know that someone wants to move something, we will take advantage of that. Yeah. We will. That's what we do.
Yeah, that's what you have to do.
Yeah, but yeah, 6 of these sold. I think we've sold, I don't know, I think we've sold like 11 or 12 of these right now. Yeah. We've sold 14 maybe. I'm not sure. I have to look. Yeah. But they're selling really well.
Yep.
This is one of the really nice things about selling these. Very assembly line like. We know exactly how much they weigh. Don't even have to weigh them. Just print them. I printed the labels. Candace matched them up with the right dolls, and now I just got to pack them. They're going to go in that one of these boxes that we bought specifically for this purpose, with a sheet of packing paper and a thank you card, and that's it. Pretty easy. Okay, got all that stuff packed. That was actually a lot of orders. That was like, that's 15 packages.
Yeah.
I already put them out for pickup, just to clear off some space. I mean, like, we are jam-packed right now with inventory. Candace, we made a couple, like, some of our buys surprise us sometimes.
Yeah, the things we weren't excited to find ended up exciting us when we found out.
Right. So, one of the things that I bought at a estate sale yesterday, Candace just listed it, this Norwegian Bliss book.
Yeah.
And you saw comps of like 35 or something?
One actually sold for 50, and then there was one recently that sold for 35. So I listed it for 40. But yeah, these are a thing, not just Norwegian, but any of the cruise lines, like the inaugural season books.
Yeah.
If you happen to find those, yeah.
So that was a nice surprise. And then another thing Candace listed while I was packing was the little license plate. I think Candace is going to get it now because she ran from me. There it is. Guess what, y'all? This thing is rare and somewhat desirable because it has old Snuggle Bear. Snuggle Bear Duffy over there.
Yeah.
So we saw comps for like 40 on this.
Right.
So what'd you list it for?
I did list it for 40. There's one other active right now, but it's got like scratches and stuff in the paint.
So came under them a little bit.
No, I matched their price.
Oh, okay. I thought they were at 45.
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, we only, what'd you pay for that? A buck?
A dollar.
Yeah. So that was surprising.
This is the second Disney license plate thing we've picked up. And the other one we sold, not real quick, but within a good time frame.
We've sold quite a few of these like souvenir license plates over the years.
Yeah.
They're not a bad pickup if, you know, unless they're.
I think people buy them and they get home and just don't ever put it on their car. And then finally they're like, why do I want that on my car? I don't know.
And then somebody else thinks, well, I want one of those. And they probably do the same thing.
Well, this is a good because some people may collect Duffy.
Right. Because he's rare, right?
Yeah. And it does have like all the 4 park icons on it. So
how many things, like eBay's been around for what, over like about 20? No, low, almost 30 years.
Almost 30 years. Yeah,
almost 30 years.
30 years. Yeah.
I wonder how much stuff has come through the shed and gotten sold on eBay and then ended up at someone else's garage sale 5 years later. And or 3 years later,
been resold again.
And then, yeah, how many things have been like recycled just kind of naturally like that, right. You know?
Yep.
All right, we got some more stuff to pull.
Okay. In the Beverly drawer.
Beverly.
Harry Potter enamel pen Hagrid.
Got him. Geek Gear exclusive.
Yes. That sold for $15.
Alrighty. Well, that's pretty good.
Yep. Walmart pen. It's not really a Walmart pen, but I stuck it in there.
Makes sense.
Yeah. $268.
Yeah, anything small, I think, makes sense to store in these, right? $268.
Yeah, maybe small jewelry. I don't want to start putting all the smalls in there. No. Keep it to the same
height. Right. Yeah, you know, lapel pins and things. We actually buy quite a few things like this, so it makes sense.
This is the Public Health Service Commissioner Corps Centennial Pin that I listed for $25. That was in one of those grab bags you got.
$25 for that little guy?
Yeah.
Heck yeah, man. Yeah. Wow. Okay, we did good on that grab bag.
Yeah.
Or actually, it was like a grab box thing, huh?
No, it was the two Ziploc bags from that estate sale.
Oh, I thought it was from a garage sale where we bought a little tub with a bunch of stuff in it. It was, actually.
Oh, was it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, we paid like $10 for...
Yeah, it was a little plastic container.
It probably had about 30 different things in it or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good deal. $25 for that. I like that.
All right, on 3 Bravo AMP Comics. It's like a Peanuts...
Okay.
Compilation. I was trying to think of the word.
3 Bravo Peanuts. Oh, okay, it's right here. Yeah, I used to read a collection of comics. Okay. Man, I used to read... Did you read Peanuts when you were a kid?
Oh, yeah.
I used to get the little paperback books.
Oh, did you?
Used paperback books. I would go with my mother to this used book place, and she would let me buy like a stack of them. They would cost her like a quarter a piece or something.
Yeah.
Which wasn't nothing back then, you know, quarter a piece, but yeah.
That was $10. That almost looks like it was like a promo thing or something, huh? The way it looks.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah.
It's 3 comic books in one.
Old Chuck. Look, yeah. He's getting blasted off the mound again. Come on, Chuck.
Yeah.
Throw in them meatballs.
I don't know if I said it. It's over $10. One Foxtrot that Master of the Universe Rotan.
A Rotan? One Foxtrot?
Yeah. That vehicle I picked up in that $10 filler bag.
Candace, you know what? We have a train set down here. I still have not listed that thing.
Oh.
That's why it's still sitting there. It's been sitting there for years because I haven't. I had two of them and something went bad with the deal and ended up not shipping it and refunding, canceling the order. And I never relisted it. So.
That's all for $14.
Okay. That came with the lot that we bought that had the little stomper in it.
Yeah.
Some other stuff, too.
9 Bravo D-Link wireless home router.
9 Bravo. Other way. 9 Bravo router. Had two of them. This was a questionable buy I made last year. Of some new inbox, old stock stuff. Because this stuff is... It's old enough to be, well, it's new enough to still be somewhat useful, but it's definitely almost antiquated at this point, and it has zero collector value, so that was kind of I think I paid like $5 for that.
I remember that sale. Their stuff was kind of pricey.
Yeah.
That's over $20.
Okay, I mean, I made profit on that one, but I have have a few other items from that buy that are going to be hard sells, I think.
We sold another clown.
Oh, yeah.
CC9, my ragdoll clown.
Okay, yeah. That's kind of a thing, huh?
Yeah.
We keep on... It's been fun watching Candace grow as a picker because she keeps on adding... It seems like every week you add another thing or two that you're on the lookout for, increasing your repertoire.
Yeah.
And now it's clowns.
That clown sold for $30.
Yeah, that's a good one. I paid $1 for that, right?
It's $3.
It's $3?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I went ahead and dug this out of the vinyl box. Deep Purple, Perfect Strangers. How much did we get for that, Candace?
$15
plus ship.
All right. We have an Xbox game. Location is 4CR-Z2.
Z. Okay, what's it called?
Legends 2 Rise of the Apocalypse.
Okay, it actually used to be on the other side, but it got shoved over here. Oh, it's an X-Men game, huh?
Yeah.
Z2, did it sell for
$6.99?
$10.99. Huh? X-Men's Rise of the Apocalypse 2?
Yeah.
Okay, I guess I must have changed my mind on how much to list it for, because I wrote $7 here. That's weird. Okay.
7 Delta, we sold a smoking motorcycle.
7 Delta?
Yeah. Fireman motorcycle.
Ah, let me just move these bras out of the way. Yeah, I had one of your bra things or whatever.
Those aren't mine.
Not yours, but you listed.
People think I'm leaving my bras laying around.
You found them. It's like back when you were leaving sandwiches and stuff around here.
Yeah, that was me.
Okay, anyway, here's the motorcycle.
$20.
Alrighty.
We have an X-Men card on 4B, B132.
All right, I'm a little nervous because we did go in. That's the box that
variations
we had problems with, and that is on a variation listing, right?
Yeah.
All right. We did like inventory this entire box. We actually inventoried pretty much all the cards.
Yeah.
But we took everything out of here and inventoried it and should have fixed everything, but I'm still a little nervous. Okay, B132 is Archangel?
Yeah.
What? You started laughing at me because I said Archangel?
Yeah.
What would you have said?
Archangel? The second thing you said?
Yeah, okay. I knew I was messing up. You know, we have to say so many words in this gig.
I'm not judging. I mess up words all the time. You know that.
We say a lot of words in this gig, you know?
Yeah.
Get a lot of them wrong, too.
That's all for $6.
Okay.
In the Boba Fett drawer, 2 George Bush buttons.
Buttons? 2 George Bush buttons. Okay, we got one with Bush and Cheney. Man, he looks so young there.
I know.
And then the other one is Bush and
Quail.
That's Daddy Bush. Yep. Okay.
$8.99 for those.
Okay.
3 Bravo, a lot of 2 cookbooks. Furniture City Feast in the Carolina Collection.
On 3 Bravo?
Yeah.
There
are 2 books.
Yeah, they're, you put them in a Ziploc together for me. Made it easy.
A lot of those together because they're both North Carolina cookbooks.
That makes sense.
$15 for those.
Gadoke.
In the cube, 2 black spoon and forks.
Yeah. I remember those.
Okay.
These are actually kind of cool.
I don't think I saw those, or I might have kept one.
Well, no, I think you did. I think I asked you if you wanted to. This is them, right? They are cool. You're going to be mad now that you didn't. Look, it's this tool. It's got a little carabiner on it, and it's got a spork.
Look at that.
And all kind of tools.
I did not see that. You hid that from me.
It's got a bottle opener. Want me to cancel the order?
Cancel the order.
I'm not. I refuse.
$15.
We can't cancel orders right now, Candace, because we have those defects from, we had 3 defects last week.
I know.
So we got to chill for a while.
All right, in the chest drawer, you're going to like this. 2 cards, Pocahontas lenticular cards.
Ooh, yeah, you know how I like my lenticulars.
Chest drawer behind you.
Oh, thank you.
Pocahontas.
Poca what? All right. Here we go. Yeah, Pocahontas, moving animation cards, 2 of them.
$15.
All right. Is that going? Let me see. It looks like they paid regular first class shipping based on that total. I don't know why I would have done that.
I think those have been listed a while, maybe before this evening.
Okay.
Yeah, they've been listed quite a while.
I'm actually okay with that because I don't think I have top loaders to fit these anyways, because
yeah,
these are really thick.
Okay. All right. We sold a hat.
Okay.
4F.
4F. And that does have an XP on it.
Yeah.
Which means cross post, which means...
It's on Poshmark.
Okay. Go ahead. Let me go grab it, and then we'll go through what we do to delist it.
Okay.
So it's 4... Wait, it's 4 Bravo?
4 Frank.
4 Frank. Oh, okay. That is this box. Which hat is it? That's fine. I'll bring the box over here, and then we'll go through the whole...
This might be that one on top.
I think it is.
Yeah.
This guy right here?
FFA, yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What do you sell for?
$15.
Oh, good. That's the thing with hats, man. Like, you can typically buy hats at garage sales and even estate sales a lot of times for $1 a piece or less, and they're slow sellers. But you sell one and you get like 10 to 15X on it. And it's like, God, how do you
Yeah.
I don't see how we could ever stop doing that.
They're easy to list.
Oh, man, they're great.
Yeah.
But they could stick around for a while. All right, let's go ahead and go through. We're going to show you how we delist something from List Perfectly. All righty. So I'm going to show y'all, first of all, this is that hat as it sits on Poshmark. So it's cross-posted to Poshmark. And then we have this little icon up here.
You want me to do it?
Yeah, go ahead and do it. Click on the icon and then go to our listings. And that gets you to... That's an easy way to get to the List Perfectly site there.
That's that extension we talked about up there.
Yeah, Google Chrome extension. So then Candace can just search for... FFA or something, find that listing. Okay, there it is. And then if you click on that thing on the left, that thing, then you can select to mark sold right here. This changes to mark sold, and it highlighted all of the potential platforms. And so when you click mark sold, listing will be ended or removed on platforms. Okay. And then it's going to work whatever.
Working in the background, it'll open a separate window for wherever it's listed at.
Yeah, it's actually going to eBay, but it's going to find on eBay that it's already been sold there. Okay. And then now it's opening Poshmark. It said successfully ended for Poshmark. And if we refresh this screen where the hat actually is,
no listing
found.
Yep.
So it just deleted it from Poshmark.
Yep.
So it's not automatic, but it's
simple and fast.
It was simple. We just went to our List Perfectly interface. You click once on the left there, and then you click the little checkbox, and then you click the thing, and then you click, it's 4 clicks. And it was pretty easy.
Yeah.
So that's how that worked.
Yep.
All right. I think I'm going to go ahead and pack up this round.
Okay.
And we'll come back and pull some more in a minute. All right. I got that round packed there. And then we have a few more eBay smalls to pull. Then we have, I think, 3 eBay bigs to pull. We're going to do those on the next clip or take or whatever. And then we also have orders on other platforms. Isn't that exciting?
Like, yeah.
That's it's pretty rare around here.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
Yeah. All right, the first item is 2 Delta, a holiday celebrations Barbie.
2 Delta.
2001.
Yeah, this was the buy that was a little sketch. I don't know. 2 Delta. Okay, holiday celebration Barbie 2001. Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. And how much did that sell for?
15.
Yeah, we paid...
5 each.
We paid 5 each for, what, 4 Barbies?
That was the lower price one I listed.
This is the lowest price one?
Yeah.
Okay, so the other ones were higher than that.
Yeah, like 20, and I think I did the Mary Poppins maybe for 30.
Okay. Yeah, so, I mean, we're going to end up doing okay on those. It wasn't a fantastic buy or anything.
The next item is cross-posted. So I'm going to have to take that down. It's a dummy perfume bottle on 9 Charlie P41.
9 Charlie P41?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And we really need to cross post way more stuff. And then after a month, after the first 4 months, let's see, P41?
Yeah.
Maybe it's this one that doesn't have a box. Okay, here it is. Yeah. So if this were actual cologne, we wouldn't be able to send it priority. But it's not. This is dummy, right?
It's just colored water in it, yeah.
Yeah, it looks like pee water, like dark dark pee water. It's a dehydrated...
It's apple juice.
Oh, apple juice. There you go. Hey, did you taste it?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you didn't.
$18 for that.
Yeah, but we're gonna reevaluate Poshmark and mostly Etsy cross-posting. Poshmark is basically just free to cross-post on because there's no listing fee or anything. Now, Etsy, on the other hand, you pay 20 cents per listing, but then the listing lasts...
4 months?
4 months. But then the way I look at it is, okay, let's say you have... Let's say we ended up with 1,000 things on Etsy. Mm-hmm. That would basically cost $200 for 4 months, or $50 a month, yeah, for a 1,000 item store.
Yeah.
Sounds reasonable to me. Like, versus like an eBay store fee or something. Now, the question though is it worth it?
Yeah, I think we need to be selective, because I think I kind of have a feel for stuff that would sell on Etsy versus eBay.
Right.
So, things like this probably, I don't know.
Yeah, we'll just have to see, and then we'll reevaluate and say, okay, this kind of item, it don't work here.
Yeah.
So we quit on this.
Yeah.
But this kind of item, this is good, so we need to,
right,
go harder with this. Because we, like, here's the fact is, like, we put the Walmart pens up on Etsy just because I wanted to find out.
And you saw a lot of listings on Etsy.
There are a lot of listings, yeah, on Etsy for Walmart pens. But if every time one sells on eBay, that means we wasted 20 cents on Etsy.
Right.
So we really have to, you know, I'm willing to try it, but it doesn't, yeah, mean we have to stay there with,
yeah,
it.
Yeah, we're just feeling it out. And, right. After 4 months, we're going to give it 4 months because it's already paid for 4 months. And then we'll kind of evaluate if we want to leave them up or take them down.
Right. Like, we don't have to sell a whole bunch of them for me to think, okay, that was worthwhile.
Yeah.
You know, because, like, the margins on those are crazy high. Yeah. So, we'll just see, though. We're going to feel this out, try it out. We need a lot more items up there, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which I don't know when I'm going to do that. I got jury duty tomorrow.
Maybe not. I'm okay. Thinking positive.
Well, I got to show up, at least.
Not if you call today and they say, we don't need you.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, that's why you're calling.
That's true.
All right, 10 Delta.
I was thinking I was probably more calling so they could kind of get a head count of how many people are actually going to show.
It's probably that, too.
Because a lot of people probably either moved and didn't get the letter, or they get the letter and they forget, or they get the letter and they intentionally don't go, or whatever.
My thought process, since they have you calling so late in the day, that there's probably like a little pre-trial thing that happened.
Right.
And it may have gotten dismissed or
settled
out of court.
Right.
So yeah, they may not need you.
Yeah. No, you're right. You're right. Most things never actually go to trial.
Yeah.
So, fingers crossed. Hey, I don't mind doing my civic duty, okay? I'm not saying that. And some of y'all said, Lonnie, you should, like, that's the backbone of our judicial system and things like that. And I agree with all of that. However, I don't have to be happy about it.
Right.
Because it has a financial impact on us. So, I'm not happy about that part. I'm not going to go in with... I'm not going to go in begging to get out of it, though. I'm going to go in, answer everything straightforwardly. I'm just going to play it straight. I'm not going to go in trying to get out. But if I get out, I'll be happy.
If you get out, people are going to think you tried and got it. But you never know. I mean, you never know what the reason is they don't.
You know the biggest thing I don't like about it? The letter says no cell phones allowed in the building. And I know I'm going to be sitting around for hours probably doing nothing.
Staring at a wall.
Well, I'm going to have to bring a book.
Can you bring a book?
Well, yeah. Why couldn't you bring a book?
I don't know.
I'm going to have to bring something. I might go buy me a crossword puzzle book.
You can hollow out a book and put your phone in there.
Yeah, okay. And then I might end up staying there for another reason then. All right, what else we got?
All right, 10 Delta, where did I get that? A vintage Looney Tunes 3-ring binder.
10 Delta, okay. We are going to be pulling everything. Actually, we're going to pull stuff now, and we're probably going to come out here later tonight if we have any, hopefully, if we have sales.
Yeah.
It happened today. And clear the deck again. Then I'm going to go in and do two-day handles on everything.
Yep.
So, yeah, there it is.
$13.
All right. Perfect. That's awesome. Where'd you get this?
I don't
remember anything about that.
MU8.
Okay.
Thermometer.
Oh yeah, this was shocking.
Right, meat thermometer.
I couldn't believe this thing sold. This we had a big bucket of
new old stock
household type stuff, yeah. And most of it was like cup holders and just like meat brushes and things like that. And Candace actually looked this up and said, "There's a market for this."
There is, yeah.
Which I was astounded. I couldn't believe. I don't know why there is, but there is.
I know. I didn't expect it. And I was $15.
Yeah, that's good. Yep. Heck yeah. We just had it sitting around in the old death pile, so that's cool.
All right, our Etsy order is a Walmart pen.
Okay.
Number 9, police officer.
Number 9. Yeah, we've sold so many of these Walmart pens now that, I mean, anything we sell out of these little things is just pure profit. You know, except for selling costs and packaging and stuff, but yeah, pretty much pure profit. And usually when I pack these up, usually I'll make a bubble wrap ball.
It's number
9. Number 9, here we go. I'll make like a bubble wrap ball that it's very like a piece of bubble wrap wrapped on just one of these and then put into a bubble mailer. It's actually a pretty good bit cheaper than using one of my little boxes, and it's extremely well protected.
We actually had a viewer ask, how do we ship these little pens? So there you go.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Typically I will do that. Now, if one is higher priced, like a $20 one or something like that, I'll use one of these boxes. But typically, this one, I might even do that with this one because that's a $17 one, right?
Sold for $17, yeah.
Plus ship.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it depends. Even though I don't think it's any more protected, I think they're equally indestructible.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, I mean, so, you have to get, run over by a car. Which
and even then,
box or mailer, it doesn't matter what it's in.
Right, no, you're right.
Okay, and then our Poshmark sale is on 2 Foxtrot, some Nightmare Before Christmas shoes.
Okay, hand painted, 2 Foxtrot. Now, this one, obviously, this is, we'll just call it fan art, okay? 2 Foxtrot, and yeah, probably won't say much more than that about it. And we don't even have them. Oh wait, we do. Okay, they're on 2 Echo. Here they are, Candace.
That's the wrong location.
That's all right. They were close by.
Those sold for $28.
No, they didn't.
No.
They sold for $35.
I'm looking at the wrong place. $35.
But we get our total proceeds after fees and everything from Poshmark is $28.
Yeah.
And then Poshmark, the way it works, they actually email you the label, or you can download the label from the site, then you print it out, so you don't actually buy the postage. It's already paid for.
Yep.
Customer did pay shipping on that, so mm-hmm. So that makes that math real easy. We sold them for $35. We paid $5 a pair for those shoes, right?
Yeah.
So we got $28 minus $5, $23 net.
Yeah.
So okay, that's all the smaller stuff,
that's
right?
Everything's small. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and get this stuff packed. Then we have 3 more orders. All right, our carrier is actually out there right now picking up packages. I can hear we can actually hear the beep,
yeah,
from the
she scans them.
She scans them, man. We can hear the beep from the shed. Beep, beep,
yep.
Beep. So yeah, our carrier is freaking awesome.
She's great. I hope we keep her forever.
I know. I wish she was younger. Just so that means
Excuse me?
No, I just, no, not for that. I mean, because that would mean she would work longer.
I know what you mean. Like, she's probably going to be retiring, what, the next
five to 10 years?
Yeah.
But, I mean, I think we got her for a while, though. She's not going to retire anytime soon.
Yeah.
We've had a couple of really good ones, and we've had some horrible ones.
Yeah.
We've had some so bad that for a while, we didn't even have, actually, I think for over a year, we didn't even have a regular person on this route. It's a rural route. Right. And every day they just use fill-ins or substitutes or whatever. And during that stretch, that's when I just had to start bringing packages. I mean, I did complain. I complained to the post office. I called the 800 number. I did this and that. And
they don't care.
They don't. I mean, yeah, if they do care, nothing happened.
Yeah.
Like, but then... then we got our current carrier, and it's been smooth sailing, except on her days off. On her days off, though, I know her days off, and only one of them is during the week. So on that day, I always go out to the mailbox. I write out a note. Scheduled pickup packages are, and I say where they're at. I tape it to the front of the mailbox, and I put the flag up.
And sometimes they even don't pick up.
Only one time recently.
One time we forgot to put the sign, and we happened to be walking out there, and she was out there like in the mailbox, and she waved at us.
She waved, and I was like, uh-uh, come here. It's so weird, like the way, and one of the big problems, according to what they tell us anyway, the way they know that they have a pickup here is they get a printout for each pickup they have. Each scheduled pickup.
Hands it to them in the morning, right?
The postmaster prints them out and drops it in their box or whatever.
Yeah.
That's how they know. And I can see, like,
it's so archaic.
If that's really how they do it, I can see why that's problematic. Because how are you gonna like remember to check that address and stuff? Like,
why aren't they using some kind of GPS system?
I think they have it.
Alerts them when they get to a stop. Package pickup.
I think they have that, and they're not using it correctly or something. That's my guess. Because they have the little device that is GPS-enabled.
It kind of tracks where they go and stuff, too, huh?
I think so. Yeah, it does. Because, like, they know there's all kind of rules about, like, they can't back their vehicle up farther than X amount of feet.
Right.
Or then it tracks their, I think it tracks their speed and location, all that kind of stuff. But anyways... we're very happy with our carrier right now. So our carrier, if you happen to watch this, please stick around for at least five more years.
We love you.
Can we sign her to a contract?
We love you even if you're not younger.
What? All right, we got a few...
some big stuff.
Some big Mr. Big Stuffs going out that are going to go UPS. So they all didn't have to go out with her.
First one is 2 Bravo Sony Handycam.
Yes. Okay. So this is...
not a Handycam, just a camcorder.
It is. I think it is called a Handycam. I may have not put that in the title. 2 Bravo up here. Here we go. And I love to ship these in the camera bags if they come with one, because that protects them. Protects them a bunch. This one we bought for $5 at a garage sale.
A family-run
estate sale. Mm-hmm. That's right. Yep. Same time we bought some Bose stuff. $5 for this, and it was one of the better ones you can get.
Silver $215.
Yep. Heck yeah, that was awesome. And it sold... I considered listing it for $200, and if I would have done that, it probably would have sold that day. But I pushed it a little bit higher... and it, instead of selling that day, it sold within like 4 or 5 days. So that was worth waiting for sure.
Mm-hmm. All right, next item, the Dymo 5 Charlie.
Sold it again. This time, I didn't put turbo. I'll go around the other side, it's easier.
I threw the bags down from the carrier.
Oh, yeah, she every now and then she brings a big old... thing of IKEA bags back to us. All right, this guy right here, Dymo power supply, print cable. The only thing it didn't have this time, it didn't have 2 packs of labels.
Yeah,
because the people that bought it and returned it before kept the friggin' labels. Candace wanted
to wait till I ever see them. They better hope I never run into them.
Candace was mad. Candace was so mad.
I took it personally for some reason.
You did. And I was like, Candace, chill. Like, like I messed up on this. Like, if the cost is two packs of labels that are probably worth about $4 or $5, whatever, I'll let it go.
I know they bought that just to get free labels.
They might have. They might have said, okay, there's one with turbo and they have labels and we can return the printer without the labels. And they won't fight it because they'll be scared they get negative feedback.
Yep.
So, yeah, whatever. All right. But still sold it for the same amount I sold the other one, sold it for before.
Yeah.
Same, $200.
All right, on 10, Charlie, you sold the Olivetti. Typewriter.
Where's that at?
10 Charlie.
Man, I wish Fontanini would have made typewriters. Olivetti, you'll do though. Okay, this guy right here. I listed both. Well, I got both of these last weekend at an estate sale for $20 for the pair. And the Olivetti sold.
Sold that for 90.
$90. That's a good one.
Yeah.
I guess 10 and a 90 basically. Is that all the big stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, these aren't hard packs at all. And as far as typewriters go, this is pretty tame.
Yeah.
Pretty small. I have been enjoying, I don't know where to keep them yet, but I have my big bubble
back there. American Bubble Boy. I forgot how big it was after what we've been using.
Don't be fooled by imitations like Chinese Bubble Boy and Korean Bubble Boy. It's American Bubble Boy. But yeah, all right, let me get this stuff packed. All right, y'all, it is later. We ate dinner and stuff. It's 8:00 now, and we're gonna do. What are you doing?
Go around and you keep turning.
Well, I didn't know you were there. But we're gonna do another order poll because I do have jury duty starting tomorrow morning.
Yeah, he called and it was a recording. You have to report if you have a letter. So.
Right. So we'll see what happens from there. Hopefully it's not an interesting story. Hopefully it's they asked me a few questions and told me to go home. But it could be more than that.
So our plan is we're going to pull orders tonight, and then after we get these pulled, turn on two-day handling.
Yep.
So that anything that sells can be packed like after he gets home. Hopefully they let him out fairly early.
Yeah. And then we'll come in and shoot some video with you guys, talk about a few things, pull some orders,
do
all that stuff. I'll edit some video. And then I'll go crash and go to sleep and hopefully do it again.
Hopefully not do it again.
I don't know.
Yeah.
We're not looking forward to this, though. But, yeah, we did make a few sales, and we've made a couple sales in the past hour or so. So, and we are starting to see some outdoorsy type things starting to sell, which is good.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Things you use outdoors?
No, you said we're starting to see some outdoorsy things, and I was like, what?
Not in here. Well, you mean like bugs and stuff? No. I hope not.
What you're talking about. First item, CC9. It's a Nike glove, softball glove.
CC9. Let's see if this is a Nike. Yes, it is. That is a Nike glove.
$22.
Okay. PSOT.
Yep.
Alrighty.
Let me move my packing stuff so you don't trip. Five Bravo Cleo Monster High Doll.
Five Bravo.
The other side.
Monster High. Oh, that's the last one.
Okay.
The magic bin's going to refill, though, I imagine. Candace just did some more Draculauras earlier. Okay.
14 for that. 10 Bravo. Ten Bravo Walmart pen, 206.
And we did already take that down off of
Etsy.
So that's like.
Did you try to make an Italian sounding?
Etsy. I don't know. No, not really. 206. 206.
It's a store number 406. Pulling together.
Yes. Pull. Hey, that's what we're doing right now. We're pulling orders together.
Yep.
So, yeah. Right on.
$8 for that one.
Okie doke. What's next?
Four Charlie another Nike glove.
Really?
Yeah, okay. This is a baseball glove. Siege 2.
For Charlie. Here it is, back here. And I don't know if these are recent listings or what. Man, that is a flat glove, huh? Look. Flat as a pancake. All right. It is a Siege 2. I see it written there. Yep.
$20 for that.
Okay. I love selling gloves. They're so easy.
All right. We have a vinyl erasure drama.
Uh-oh. The reason I say uh-oh is because this is not the most organized thing. Erasure drama. Okay. I got it. Erase your drama, Maxi Signal. Okay.
That's over $10.
Alrighty.
Alrighty, and the last thing is a hat I just listed this afternoon.
She sold a hat.
I sold a hat. Right here.
Presidential Protective Division hat.
Secret Service hat, $25.
Okay. Yeah, that is kind of cool. I wonder how you get those.
You probably have to work for the Secret Service.
You think?
Yeah.
You don't think they have a gift shop?
You found that at that estate sale where we got those other hats.
Yeah, yeah. Yep, right, sure
that's
did.
That's everything. So we're going to go ahead and turn on two-day handling.
Yes.
And get this stuff packed up.
Yes. And several of y'all, I want to talk about the cross-posting thing real quick. Because several of y'all have mentioned Mercari. And we are going to do Mercari. I don't know when exactly, but soon. The reason we started with Poshmark and Etsy is because I already had established accounts there, and I've sold on both of those platforms in the past. So we are going to start adding in Mercari. I actually did a post that was pretty interesting in the Facebook group, link below, Reseller Water Cooler. Did a post asking for some input on a few things about Mercari. And it's pretty interesting. There's a lot of information in there.
Yeah.
Because
a lot of good responses.
Yeah, because we are noobs.
Yeah, I've only shopped on there. I haven't sold.
I mean, we are 100% noobs on there. It feels weird not knowing anything.
Yeah.
And kind of fun, because like it's interesting. You know, selling on eBay is still kind of fun, but it's not very interesting. It's
this
like
this will be a break from the routine.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Which might be interesting for y'all too. So, but yeah, I don't know when we're gonna do Mercari, add Mercari in. Probably after I get done with this jury duty thing, though.
Yeah.
I think we're just gonna try and survive while jury duty's going down.
Yep.
And all right, so yeah, I'll get this stuff packed, and we will see y'all again very soon. Thanks a bunch for watching, y'all.
Bye.